going along with the video that was just recently posted on testing the electrical components of our domestic sewing machine motors, I was also asked to show how I clean the commutator bars on the rotors. Now, I do that using a Ferree bench motor. We actually have two of these here in the shop. Well, one in this shop, one out in the garage shop. And I lightly chuck it into the Jacobs chuck on the motor. Now, this motor has a foot switch to get her to control it. So, I get myself in position. What I'm going to use to start the cleaning process is I'm going to take a piece of a strip of Scotch-Brite. Now, if you've ever done any wood turning, you like if you're making pens or bowls or whatnot, you would know that if you're going to be sanding something that's rotating like this, you would do it from the bottom. You see how the direction of rotation would carry that. Now you don't grip the paper. You don't grip. In this case, we're not going to grip the Scotch-Brite either. We're not wearing. Actually, I'm going to take my wristwatch off. So here, no bracelets, no rings. And I'm not going to grip this. I'm going to hold it lightly underneath. I'm going to start the motor up, and I'm going to bring the Scotch-Brite in contact with the commutators. So as you can see how I do that. I'm going to do it actually with my left hand. I'm not gripping that. I'm just holding it. That way, if anything were to happen to grab it, it would just pull away from me. And you'll see it got a whole bunch of schmoo off, but it's still not perfect. Still not really good. Now I'm going to go to a 400 grit foam cord nail file. I'm just on the commutator bars. I'm not going any farther in towards the rotating mass. I'm going to flip it over and hit it with a 600 grit side. And that's looking better. Now, going to continue with 600 grit, which is this black here. I'm going to swing it around. The white side here is 4000 grit. And then I'm going to flip it over because this light gray side is 12000 grit. And I want to show you something when we get done with the 12000. Alright, now you'll see, let me see if I can get that in closer. You see all that copper that's on the abrasive. Yeah, I'm going to have to uncheck that here. Now I'm going to hold up. You'll see there's a lot of that copper waste in between the commutator bars. I'm going to clean that off right now. I'm going to hold the rotating mass over a trash can that's got some paper towel in it, pointed down, and hit the commutator bar areas with quick drying contact cleaner. All right, I flushed that out with the quick drying contact cleaner, and now all of the residue is gone from between the commutator bars, so there'll be no short circuiting. The bars are clean, and they're looking good. Well, that's all I got for you on this one. Thanks for watching. See you on the next one.